Given f of x equals the quantity x plus 2 squared, we want to determine the domain, so f of x is increasing and 1 to 1. We also want to give the range and use interval notation. So here's a graph of our function f of x. Notice if we don't restrict the domain, this function is not 1 to 1 because horizontal lines would intersect this graph in more than one point. Notice the function is also decreasing on the left and increasing on the right. So notice if we consider this function only from the vertex to the right, the function is increasing, and it's also 1 to 1 because horizontal lines would only intersect this half of the graph at one point. So now we'll determine the domain and range if we only want this half of the graph. Well, the domain is a set of all possible x values, so if we project this graph onto the x-axis, notice how the domain would be from negative 2 to the right, or from negative 2 to infinity, and it would include the vertex, so we'll include negative 2 in the domain. So the domain, using interval notation, would be from negative 2 to infinity, and it's closed on negative 2, meaning it includes negative 2. We could also express this using inequalities as x is greater than or equal to negative 2. Now let's consider the range. The range is a set of all possible y values or outputs of this function on the restricted domain. Well, if we project this graph onto the y-axis, notice how the smallest y value would be 0, and from there it increases upward toward positive infinity. So the range would be the interval from 0 to infinity closed on 0, meaning it includes 0, or we could say y is greater than or equal to 0. With this restriction, the function f is now 1 to 1, so we can find f inverse of x. To do this, let's first write the original function replacing f of x with y. So we'd have y equals the quantity x plus 2 squared. And then to find the inverse, we interchange the x and y variables and then solve for y. So we have x equals the quantity y plus 2 squared. And now we'll solve this for y. The first step, we'll take the square root of both sides of this equation. So we'd have the square root of x equals the square root of the quantity y plus 2 squared. So we have the square root of x equals, normally this would be the absolute value of y plus 2, but because of the restrictions here, we don't have to worry about that. This would just be y plus 2. Last step, we'll subtract 2 on both sides. We have the square root of x minus 2 equals y. This is our inverse function, solve for y. So we'll go ahead and replace y with f inverse of x. F inverse of x is equal to the square root of x minus 2. And we're also asked to give the domain and range. Let's go ahead and do that. Because this is the inverse of function f, the domain of f is going to be the range of f inverse, and the range of f will be the domain of f inverse. So the domain will be from 0 to infinity, closed on 0, and the range will be the interval from negative 2 to infinity. Let's go ahead and finish by verifying this graphically. We know that if we graph function f on the restricted domain, and we graph the inverse function on its domain, the two functions should be symmetrical across the line y equals x. And here's the graph of the original function on the restricted domain. And here's the graph of the inverse function graphed over its domain. Now we can see that these two graphs are symmetrical across the line y equals x. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.